You can see characteristical modification of this ECG for second degree of St. Atrial blood. The blue arrows represented normally transmitted impulses and resulting in P waves. And the black arrows, you can very good see, represent blocked sinus impulses, dropped P waves. The pulses around the dropped P waves, 2.1 seconds, are exactly double the precedent PP interval, 1.05 seconds. It's very good C characteristically for this type of SINA atrial block. In this slide, you could see several cases of type 2 second degree of SINA atrial block. You can see, because in this case, it's very important to appreciate the PP interval. In this case, you can see drop of P wave, because in this case, if we registration PP intervals, you can see PP twice. And can be other situation when we have PP interval, and in this case, it's not registration P, but this is PP interval from last, from next P wave, it will be free PP intervals. Or can be second degree types two, when we have 2-to-1 block. In this case, you can see PP interval with dropped P waves. Here, we have two ECG, up ECG, it's dedicated type 1, second degree of SINA atrial block, because in this case we have PP, first PP 1000 millisecond, and next will be 900, and next 820. And disappear P, disappear P. It's characteristical for type 1. And for type 2, when we have fixed PP interval, 907, and distance from last P and for next P, we have exactly twice PP wave previously. It's characteristical for second degree type 2 of SINA atrial block. I think it's easy to remember. Other ECG with type 2 second degree of SINA atrial block, you can see it's characteristical for type 2. Why? Because PP interval, the same interval, PP is the same interval, and sometimes can be registration disappear P wave and disappear follow QRS contacts. It's characteristical for type 2. Now let's discuss about third degree of SINA atrial block. What characteristical for this situation? None of the sinus impulses are conducted to the right atrium. This is a complex abscess of P waves. The onset of third degree of SINA atrial block may produce long sinus pauses or sinus arrest, may lead to fatal asystole. Rhythm may be maintained by a junctional escape rhythm. If you look at this ECG, you can see first complex is normal because we have before QRS complex P wave, QRS complex, all elements on the electrocardiogram and next disappear P wave, disappear P wave, we have junctional rhythm. Next is junctional because it's not registration P wave before QRS complex. Junctional rhythm because QRS complex is not dilated. It's normal time of QRS complex. What why we consider is junctional or from atrioventricular node. Sinus pause is not a multiple of the PPM interval. And sinus arrest is longer than a sinus pause and is not a multiple of the PP interval. I hope you would see this situation or when on the ECG is not registration, a long time P wave and follow QRS complex. It's characteristic for patients with a third degree of sinoatrial block or complex block. As ECG with sinus arrest, with junctional escape beep, you can see disappear P wave, but in this case, registration QRS complex without P wave before this. It's characteristic for complex sinoatrial block. This slide is very good for students because here they could see first is normal ECG, sorry, normal ECG, P, PQ, QRS, P, PQ, QRS, it's normal time, normal is regular sinus rhythm. First time when we have modification of PP interval. In this case, real PP interval shortness before the pause. Shortness before the pause. And type 2, when we have PP intervals are fixed. And set degree or complex sinoatrial block, when we not registration P wave before QRS complex, but we have only registration QRS complex. It's junctional escape rate. I hope you remember, it's very easy to remember, different types of sinoatrial block. First degree, second degree, and complex or set degree of sinoatrial block. First degree, you saw, it's very, very difficult to appreciate it only with registration ECG. Only with electrophysiological study, it's possible to appreciate it, this type of block. When you have patients with complex sinoatrial block, usually we can help patients only with implantation of permanent pacemakers. Permanent pacemakers are the mainstay of therapy for patients with symptomatic sinoatrial node dysfunction. Why we can see about symptomatic? Because sometimes can be patients with second degree of sinoatrial block characteristical symptoms. What why? Not only for patients with complex sinoatrial block, but sometimes patients with second degree, it's necessary to implantation permanent pacemaker. In this slide, you can see permanent pacemaker. It's battery connected with electrode, and this electrode usually we installation in the right cavities of the heart, in right ventricles, anterior ventricles. And this is pacemaker, usually generation 70 impulse per minute. 70 impulse per minute. It's good possibility to help patients with these disorders. Now let's discuss about other group dedicated atrioventricular block. Atrioventricular block. Atrioventricular block is partial or complex interruption of impulse transmission from the atria to the ventricles. I think it's very easy to understanding. The most common causes of atrioventricular block are idiopathic fibrosis and sclerosis of the conduction system. Usually about 50% of patients has this type of atrioventricular block. Ischemic heart disease, 40%. After using different drugs, usually a long period, beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, digoxin, amiodarone. Where patients with increased vagal tone, sometimes can appear patients with different valvulopathy. Valvulopathy can be when patients has or mitral valvulopathy or aortic valvulopathy, or sometimes can appear when we have patients with congenital heart or genetic or other disorders. Now let's talk about first degree of atrioventricular block. First degree. All normal P waves are followed by QRS complexes, but the PR interval is longer than normal. I hope you remember normal P wave, PQ interval, QRS complex. I say about duration. In this slide, you can see PR interval. PR interval. If Q interval, this Q wave in this case will be PQ interval. If not the registration Q wave, in this case we consider PR interval more than 0.20, sometimes 21 seconds. Because normal duration of PQ interval is considered between 0.12, 0.2 seconds. In this case, I hope you see registration 0.26 is more than normal. Next, the same situation, 0.26. What why I hope is very easy to remember first degree of atrioventricular block, when we have only increased PQ interval, more than normal duration, more than 0.2021. In this ECG, you can see with red low P wave, and if we appreciate it, P when starting P, not on final, on starting P, from here to appear first wave of QRS complex, it's considered PQ or PR interval. In this case, if we registration more than 0.21 second, it's first degree of atrioventricular block. Other ECG with 12 lead registration. Usually it's normal when we have first standard leads and additional leads, and by Wilson, chest leads, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. And if you attentively look, usually P wave, good registration in second standard leads. In this case, you can see PR. It's more than normal. Because in other leads, it's not so good registration. In second degree, you can see. This is criteria for first degree of atrioventricular block. Increase PQ interval more than normal, more than 0.21. first degree of atrial ventricular block may be physiologic in young patients with high vagal tone and in well-trained athletes. An early sign of degenerative disease of the conduction system or a transient manifestation of myocarditis, rarely symptomatic, and no treatment is required, but further investigation may be indicated. If before you, young patient, 20, 25 years ago, in this case, if your registration PQ more than 0.21, but not more than 0.22, can be normal for this well-trained person. But if you have person to live more than 60 years with PQ registration more than 0.21, will be 0.25. In this case, it's necessary to compare with ECG registration 1 year ago or 2 years ago. In this case, will be very good to compare. This is to ECG. But further investigation may be help us to appreciate it next treatment. Second degree of atrial ventricular block. What characteristic of modification can register? Not every atrial implant is able to pass through the atrioventricular node in the ventricles. In this group can be two types, Mobitz type 1 and Mobitz type 2. Mobitz type 1, more common called Venke-Bach-Samoylov block by authors, and the Mobitz type 2. Venke-Bach-Samoylov block is almost due to a block within the atrioventricular node. Each successive atrial impulse encounters a longer and longer delay in the atrioventricular node until one impulse, usually every third or fourth, fails to make it through. In this slide, you can see per localization modification of these conductor systems. In this case, can be atrioventricular node, atrioventricular node. Type 1 of second degree of atrioventricular block. What characteristical ECG signs we can appreciate it when you have ECG before you? The PR interval progressively lengthens with each beat, and then suddenly a P wave is not followed by a QRS complex. A PR drop beat, such as Venke-Bach-Samoylov phenomenon. Atrioventricular nodal conduction reasons with the next beat, and the sequence is repeated. Now, let's to see together Mobitz type 1. What characteristical in this case will be? When we have progressively increased PQ interval. For example, first, PQ interval 0.20. Next, PQ 0.27. Next, registration P, but not registration following QRS complex. Disappear QRS complex. Next, PQ interval 0.20, PQ interval 0.26, and disappear correspondence. Sometimes can be 0.25, 0.27, 0.29, and disappear. It depends of a situation. This slide you can see ACG with type MOBITS type 1. PQ interval, because registration Q say PQ interval. 0.21, 0.25, 0.28, and P registration and not registration QRS complex, because we have MOBITS type 1, Samoilov-Denkebach period. Because this is increased PQ interval, it's considered by auto Denkebach-Samoilov period. Characteristically for second degree of atrial ventricular block, MOBITS type 1. P waves and QRS complexes are normal, but if you attentively look, PR interval progressively lengthens, drop beats non-conducted P wave, leads to group beating, and the block is almost always within the atrioventricular nerve. Other features of atrioventricular block. Second degree MOBITS 1. It's characteristically for this type, PP interval remains relatively constant. The greatest increase in PR interval duration is typically between the first and second beats of the cycle. The PRR interval progressively shortens with each beats. It's a mistake that PR interval progressively shortens with each beats of the cycle. The Denkebach-Samoilov pattern tends to repeat in pair QRS groups with ratios of 3 to 2, 4 to 3, or 5 to 4. In this slide, we can see modification of PQ interval. You can see increase intensity, and disappear per registration, and disappear follow QRS complex. It's characteristically for MOBITS 1. In this slide, you can see ACG 4 to 3, 4 P waves, and 3 QRS complex. P, it's fixed here, it's very good to see. PQ fixed. And next, disappear QRS complex. Here, you can see duration, 1920. And between two RR, and absent QRS complex. And here we have the same duration, when we have type 1 MOBITS of atrioventricular block. Which causes can lead to appear type 2, MOBITS type 2 of atrioventricular block? If you have patients with myocardial infarction localization in anterior part. Due to septal infarction with necrosis of the bundle branches. Or if you have patients with idiopathic fibrosis of the conducting system. Can appear after cardiac surgery, especially surgery occurring close to the septum. Usually when we have different situation, mitral valve repair, or if you have inflammatory conditions such as rheumatic fever, myocarditis, or if you have autoimmune diseases, if you have infiltrative myocardial diseases, or after a long period using different drugs such as beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, digoxin, or amiodarone. I hope you remember causes of atrioventricular blocks, Mobitz type 2. What clinical significance can appear in patients with this type of atrioventricular block? Mobitz 2 is much more likely than Mobitz 1 to be associated with hemodynamic compromise, severe bradycardia, and progression to set degree heart block. Onset of hemodynamic instability may be sudden and unexpected, causing syncope, can be a characteristic syndrome, Morgan-Adams-Stokes attacks, or sudden cardiac death. The risk of asystole is around 35% per year. Mobitz 2 mandates immediate admission for cardiac monitoring, backup temporary pacing, and ultimately insertion of a permanent pacemaker. Mobitz type 2 of this atrioventricular block is due to a block below the atrioventricular node in the His bundle. It resembles Venckerbach block in this in that sign, but not all of the atrial impulses are transmitted to ventricles. What criteria we can find on the ECG? Progressive lengthening of the PR interval does not occur. Two or more normal beats with normal PR intervals and then a P wave that is not followed by a QRS complex, a drop beat. The cycle is repeated. The ratio of conducted beats to non-conducted beats is really constant, with the ratio of P waves to QRS complex varying from 2 to 1 or 3 to 2 or so on. In this slide, you can see PQ interval constant. PQ interval constant is the same, but P registration and disappear QRS complex. The same situation, P, Q constant is the same, but disappear after P QRS complex. It's characteristic for type 2, Mobitz type 2 of second degree of atrioventricular block. Other ECG with the same situation. When we have PQ constant, but sometimes after P disappear QRS complex. It's characteristic for a second degree of atrioventricular block. Other ECG with 3-1 block. What is this 3-1 block? When we have P wave 3 and only one QRS complex. Only one QRS complex. With arrow, you can see 1, 2, 3 P and one QRS complex. The atrial rate is approximately 90 beats per minute. The ventricular rate is approximately 30 beats per minute, because in this case we have different pacemaker. First or main pacemaker, sinoatrial node generated 90 beats per minute, and bundle His in this case generated only 30 beats per minute. What why? In this case, we have registration dilated of QRS complex. Because duration of normal QRS complex is not more than 0.1 second. But here we have 0.25 seconds. Not every set P wave is almost entirely constant with the T wave. Now let's see together other ECG with second degree, consider high grade of atrioventricular block. Why? Because with a row you can see P wave, P wave, P wave, P wave, and in this case we can appreciate it for P wave, only one ventricular complex. In this case we have 4-2-1. It's considered high grade of atrioventricular block. Question: is it a Wenckebach block or a Mobitz type 2 block? What is your opinion? If you attentively look at this ECG, it's very important to appreciate it. PQ interval. PQ interval. PQ interval. We have in this ECG PQ. This is P, but not registration QRS complex. PQ, this is PQ, is the same previously PQ. Next, P and not registration QRS complex. P here. P, not registration QRS complex. In this case, will be 2-1. 2-1. 2 P wave, only one QRS complex. It's Mobitz type 2. Mobitz type 2, because we have PQ fixed. PQ fixed. Next group, next type of set degree of atrioventricular block. Because in this case, we call complex PAR block. What characteristic criteria will be for this block? No atrial impulses at all make it true to activate the ventricles. The site of the block can be either of the atrioventricular node or lower. The ventricles respond by generating an escape rate, 30, 45 beats per minute. In this case, it will be idioventricular escape. Atria are contracted in their own rhythm, and the ventricles are working in their own rhythm. Because in this case, no relationship between the activity. The atria and ventricles have nothing to do with each other, separated by the absolute barrier of the complex conduction block, because in this case, you have the atrioventricular dissociation. The atria and the ventricles are being driven by independent pacemaker. What why is very good to know about what types of pacemaker has our heart. Main pacemaker, sine atrial node. Second pacemaker is atrioventricular node. And sometimes can be KISS bundle independent pacemaker. What, why? In set degree of atrioventricular block, we can registration P wave with 80, 19 beats per minute, and complex, ventricular complex, with 30, 35, 40 beats of general impulse per minute. Set degree heart block has important hemodynamic consequences, such as syncope, dizziness, and acute heart failure are common. When the ESKP pacemaker rate is more than 40 beats per minute, symptoms are less acute and include lethargy, or sometimes can appear hypotension and dyspnea. Because in this case can appear acute heart failure, with increased pressure and less circulation. Criteria for this type of atrioventricular block will be P waves marching across the rhythm strip at the rate 60-100 waves per minute, but bearing no relationship to the QRS complexes that appear at a much slower escape rate. QRS complexes are wide and bizarre. Just the premature ventricular contractions implying a ventricular origin. Attentively look at this ECG. P registration, P waves. But sometimes it's very, very difficult to do appreciation because at the same time we have the contraction of atrium and ventricles. And in this case, it's necessary very attentively look at the ECG and appreciate PP interval and RR interval. In this case, will be rhythm of PP intervals constant, characteristic for 75-80 beats per minute, and ventricular contraction, RR interval. With this interval, we have appreciated a ventricular rhythm with 35 or 40 inputs per minute. I think it's easy to remember. PP contraction with 75-80 beats per minute and QRS complexes appear on the ECG with own rhythm with 35-40 beats per minute. Other ECG with set degree of atrioventricular block, because in this case we have complex heart block. Let's to see together. The same situation. It's necessary to find P wave. P. Only a complex QRS. In this leads, very good see. P wave, P. And if you attentively look, it's not possible to find relationship between P and QRS complex. Because this is main criteria for set degree of atrioventricular blocks. When we can't appreciate the relationship between contraction of atrium and contraction of ventricles, it's characteristic for set degree of atrioventricular block. Other patient, the same, you read the rule, you can see contraction of atrium. It's not relationship between P and QRS complex. QRS complex has own rhythm. Usually in this case, will be, let's do count together, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0.7, 60 divided 0.7, but it depends what speed we use to registration ECG, because sometimes we can use 50 milliliters a second, and sometimes we can use 25. It depends, because if registration with 25 in this case will be twice time of registration. Set degree or complete hard line. P wave and only sporadically appear ventricular contraction. And P wave is very, very difficult to appreciate. It's very, very difficult to appreciate. Only contraction of ventricles. It's characteristically sometimes can for these patients. Clinical significance. Patients with third degree heart block are at high risk of ventricular standstill and sudden cardiac death. They require urgent admission for cardiac monitoring, backup temporary pacing, and usually insertion of a permanent pacemaker. The same situation within sinus atrial block, third degree, and when we have symptomatically second degree of sinus atrial block. In this slide, you can see all groups with atrioventricular blocks. Atrioventricular blocks. Up ACG is characteristic for first degree when we have only increase of PQ interval. You can see 0.28. Second degree, we have two types. First type, when we have increase PQ interval, next more than previously. You can see 0.18, next 0.25, and disappear QRS complex. It's characteristic for type 1. And for type 2 of second degree of atrioventricular blocks, usually you can appreciate it PQ fixed the same in all leads, and sometimes after P disappear QRS complex. It's Mobitz 2 block of atrioventricular block. And complex atrioventricular block, when on the ACG, it's not possible to appreciate it, some relation between atrium and ventricle. Atrium and ventricle, it's not possible. It's not relationship between them. In this case, contraction of atrium will be, because in this case, working main pacemaker will be 75-80 beats per minute, no beats, and 75-8 impulse per minute registration on the ACG. But beats of heart will be only 30 or 35. In this case, it's necessary to appreciate it using formula 60 divided to RR interval. In this case, we can appreciate it heart beats per minute. It's characteristic for complex atrioventricular block or set degree of atrioventricular block. Now, let's talk about bundle branch block. This is refers to a conduction block or slowing of current flow in either the left or right bundle branches. First, let's talk about right bundle branch block. In this disorder, the right branch of the bundle is blocked. If you attentively look at this slide, you can see locate block of right bundle. But the septum in this case is activated and from the left go to right, because in this case we have normal heart. The left ventricular wave is preserved, as in the initial R wave over right chest leads. The left ventricle is then depolarized, producing an C wave and right chest leads, and an R wave and left chest leads. Finally, the polarization reaches the right ventricles and so produces an R in the right chest leads and a deep road as wave in the left chest leads. It's very important to understanding when we have block of right bundle branch, it's possible to activate it of these cells by septum of left ventricles, because in this case impulse go to right ventricle, and it's possible to activate it with this A right ventricle. Now let's talk about causes of right bundle branch block. This slide you can see right ventricular hypertrophy. Let's think together. When can be right ventricular hypertrophy? Or in core pulmonale, because modification of core appear in chronic pulmonary disease, it's called core pulmonale. What, why? When we have right ventricular hypertrophy, usually can appear in situation when we have chronic pulmonary disease. Or when we have pulmonary embolus, chronic pulmonary embolus, because if you have acute pulmonary embolus, it's the same situation. But it's not will be hypertrophy of right ventricle. It will be modification of right ventricle with right block of bundle block. Or if you have right heart disease located in the right ventricle, rheumatic heart disease, myocarditis or cardiomyopathy. Or when we have degenerative disease of the conduction system. When you have congenital heart disease, I hope you know about triadafalo, tetradafalo, pentadafalo. But in this situation, can be atrial septal defect. In this case, can appear this is block. What characteristical criteria can be on the ACG? Usually includes the following. QRS duration greater than 0.12 seconds. If you remember, normal duration of QRS complex is not more than 0.1. Usually between 0.06, 0.1 seconds. If you appreciate it more than 0.1, or it will be 0.12 seconds, it's characteristic for modification of time of QRS contraction. Usually, when we have right bundle branch block, on the ACG, we will be registration as RR, or called rabbit ears. For a tall R wave in leads 1, V1, and V2 with ST segment depression and T wave inversion. And reciprocal changes in V5, V6, and standard first leads, and in additional other L leads. If you attentively look, you can see characteristic modification in first standard lead, C wave, characteristic for this situation, but usually in chest or thoracic leads, V1, we can see characteristic RS R' rabbit ears. Rabbit ears. It's characteristic for this block. For this block. In this slide, you can see various right branch block. Usually, we can better see lead V1. You can see characteristic change of QRS complex in V1. Other case. It's other case. If you will see on V1, this is modification of QRS complex, it's characteristic for right bundled bench block. Other HCG, the same situation in V1, you can see characteristic modification of QRS complex. Other ACG with characteristic in V1, because in normal situation, this ACG can appear in pulmonary embolism. Pulmonary, when we have registration in set degree QR, but deep Q, and characteristic modification of a QRS complex in V1. The same situation you can see in V1, very, very good registration modification of QRS complex. It's characteristically for block of right bundled. Incomplete of this block, defined as an RSR pattern in V1, in V2, in V3, with QRS duration less than 1.12 seconds. It's a normal variant, commonly seen in children. In this case, usually not clinical significance. Let's two sit together. It's a young patient with V1 registration for incomplete block, because in this case, QRS complex duration, it's not more than 0.1 second. Now let's talk about left bundle branch block. In this slide, you can see block, because in this case, impulse generated in atrioventricular, it's not possible to reach in left ventricle because we have pathological modification. When the left branch of the bundle is blocked, the intraventricular septum is activated from the right instead of from the left side of the initial vector. It's directed to the left. Because of this, the normal initial Q wave in the left ventricular leads is lost, being replaced by a small R wave. Right ventricular depolarization, which follows, produces an R in V1 and an S in V6. The left ventricles is finally depolarized, resulting in an R in V6 and broad S in V1. The QRS duration is increased to 0.12 seconds or more. The abnormal left ventricular depolarization sequence in left bundle branch block causes secondary repolarization changes. Consequently, the ST segment and T wave are abnormal. In which cases can appear left bundle branch block? Usually, it's pathological situation. This is pathological situation will be associated with following: hypertension, ventricular hypertrophy, vascular heart disease, myocarditis. Ischemic heart disease, usually when we have patients with myocardial infarction, heart failure, and cardiomyopathy. Framingham Heart Study that acquired left bundle branch block was associated with 7 times as great a risk of heart failure, 2 times as great a risk of coronary artery disease. It's necessary to remember when can appear left bundle branch block. Usually only we have causes, because if our causes is not appear, this is block. If you have ischemic heart disease, vascular heart disease, valvular heart disease, usually when we have modification of aortic valve, insufficiency, aortic valve, or can be aortic stenosis. In this case, will be ventricular hypertrophy, and can appear block of left bundle branch. Criteria of ECG: wide QRS complex measuring more than 0.12 seconds, usually in V1 will be QS or RS complexes, in V6 and leads of left side of ventricular septum 1 and other L will be septal Q waves absent, monophasic R, RR, plural R or M-shaped R, onset or intrascoid deflection of R peak time is prolonged, will be more than 0.05 seconds. I hope at the last lecture, Dr. Oksana discussed about this is modification of the ECG characteristic for ischemic heart disease, myocardial infarction, with modification of the ECG characteristic for this block. Let's to see together, this is ECG and left bundle branch block. Usually the QRS complexes are wide. We have a QS or RS complexes in V1 and tall monophasic R wave and V6 without septal U wave. I hope you see in first standard leak, it's tall R wave, and usually in V5 and in V6, the same situation, tall R waves. And in this case, in V5 and in V6, will be negative T waves. It's characteristic for this situation. The same situation you can see in first standard lead and in V5 and V6. Other situation when we have modification of ECG, but in this case we have modification of QRS complex, duration more than 0.1 second, will be 0.12 or more. And in this case, you can see in V5 and V6 discordant STL event and modification characteristic of it. The ECG above is from a 77 years old woman with left ventricular systolic dysfunction with mild mitral valve stenosis. The rhythm is atrial fibrillation, and left bundle branch block is also seen. Let's do interpretation together. Why atrial fibrillation? Because before QRS complex absent P wave. You can't see P wave before QRS complex. You attentively look, RR interval is different. Usually will be diastolic murmurs on the apex. It's characteristic for mitral stenosis. The notes that P wave need to suggest left atria abnormality. You can see P wave. P wave usually it's not more than 0.1 second. If you have P wave more than 0.1 second, it's considered hypertrophy of left atrium. Left atrium can be hypertrophy in mitral stenosis. What, why? On the ECG, you can appreciate it, two hands of P waves, it's characteristic for mitral stenosis because it will be hypertrophy of left atrium. Kia, you can appreciate it, ventricular extrasystolia. Ventricular extrasystole is premature contraction. Premature contraction. Why ventricular extrasystole? Because we have QRS complex more than 0.1 second. And before QRS complex, it's not possible to appreciate the P wave. And in this case, you consider is ventricular extrasystolia. And finally, I think it will be very good to repeat steps of interpretation any ECG. First question, is the rhythm sinus out? If you appreciate P wave before each QRS complex, it's sinus rhythm. Second question, is it regular? Next question, is appreciate the heart rate. Later we'll talk about this is possibility. Appreciate the electrical axis of the heart. And next, describe all the waves and intervals, such as P wave, QRS complex, T wave, measure the intervals by QLPR interval, QRS. Sinus rhythm. When we have P wave before each QRS complex, it's sinus rhythm. It's regular. Regularity of the cardiac rhythm is appreciated by counting the RR intervals. RR intervals should be equal or no different than 0.1 seconds between them. I think it's easy. Next, determining the heart rate. In this case, usually we use special formula. If you have registration ECG with speed 15 millimeters per second, we use 6000 divided to an. An is number of big squares. Usually, big squares have five small ones in it. Or 600 divided to RR interval. 600, or it depends on the situation. If you have registration with speed 25, in this case, will be 300. If you have RR interval of the heart's electrical activity. Abnormalities of axis can be in ventricular enlargement or if you have conduction block. And usually, R2 more than R3, the axis is horizontal or tend to left. And R2 more than R3 and R3 more than R1, the axis is vertical. And R3 next R1 and R1, the axis is tend to right. This is situation left. Say, we've reviewed the ECG, X-ray examination, echo cardiography, Holter monitoring, nuclear scan, etc. And still no diagnosis. and right answer. Think we should break down and do a history and physical examination. But why? I want to say, only with ECG, it's very difficult to appreciate the diagnosis. But with ECG, this, I thank you for attention. I hope you receive good information.
Mas você não tem que três vezes de copo. Nu, m-am mai deconectat, parcurs că am mai sunat unul altul.
Ai,
dar, dar în general am stat destul de mult.
Da? Și ce impresie?
Bună, dar spați să vă sun pe telefon, că e totuși steu.
E clar, am înțeles.